So I'm sitting here talking to you, and we're talking about your fact that you've lost your studies and the reasons why you've been thrown off the course. But you're now how many days into a hunger strike?
It's my 10th day.
Your 10th day. How are you feeling?
I should feel sick, and I feel dizzy, of course, and it's hard for me. Like, during my hunger strike, I was attending all my classes, and I was doing my exams and submitting all my assignments. Alhamdulillah, everything was perfect, and nothing stopped me. And suddenly today, it just happened that they said it at my face that we don't want to see you anymore on campus. I had that in mind, that probably they will kick us all out, you know.
How many of you?
Actually, today, the list I have made, it's like more than 40.
Why have they done this?
You just cannot talk in Bahrain. Whenever you talk, then you're in a big problem, you know? And
But you're doing more than talking. You're on a hunger strike.
That's why I'm on a hunger strike, because there is nothing else I can do, you know? My brother is in prison. My uncle is in prison. My cousin is in prison. My friends, relatives, everyone I know is in prison.
Why are they in prison?
Because, as the government says, that they have been involved in illegal protests, or they were talking about things that they are not allowed to talk about, which is politics, you know? He was arrested at this house, you know? They break in at 2 a.m. in the morning.
In here.
First of all, to be honest, I was scared. I was scared to death. My legs started to shake, because I was asleep, and I opened the door, and there were, like, the hall was full of men, covered, face covered, like criminals.
Balaclava.
Yes.
Black covered.
Black with eyes shown and mouth, and with normal clothes, and some of them were riot police. They hold guns. They started to ask me and direct questions to me that, where is Muhammad?
Your brother.
Yeah, I told them that I don't know.
So by speaking out against this, you have now lost your position, your studies at Polytechnic.
Actually, yes, I did. I was clueless. There is nothing I can do. I've lost my identity over Facebook. I'm using a fake account, you know. I'm using a fake name. Just
why?
They will arrest me.
Won't they arrest you for doing this interview?
I don't know.
What do you think?
I don't know. But I'm not doing this to get attention of the government. I'm doing this for the world to know what's happening in Bahrain. A 20-year-old female has nothing else to do to save her brother. You know? This is the last thing I could do. It's not an easy thing not to eat, you know? It's not an easy thing.
And still nothing from your brother? You've still heard nothing?
Actually, there are some good news. Yesterday, they called us for a visit. And we're visiting him today at 7 p.m.
Are you going to see him tonight?
Yes.
You must be really happy.
I'm so happy. Like, it's worth it. What I did, like, I didn't eat for a few days, it's worth it. And I'm not going to stop this hunger strike until my brother gets released, and my uncle, and my cousin, and all the political prisoners in Bahrain.